A good tool we can use in dynamic models where you have modes or natural frequencies of the structure is something called a modal assurance criterion. Modal assurance criterion, or MAC, tells you how similar two mode shapes are. I'm going to kind of draw on the slides here because I like to draw. You know, we have two mode shapes here, and they have some vectors, right? Mm-hmm. Let's see if I can find my mouse. So a vector here and a vector over here. And we take the dot product of these vectors. And if these things are moving together the same direction, then the dot product is one. If one of these dot products was orthogonal to the other, like this, so that one is orthogonal to the same point on the structure adjacent, then the dot product is zero. And in this case, if we were to look at all the points, are they all moving the same from the mode shape on the left versus the right, Nick?
I would say yes. They all appear to be moving in the same direction.
Yeah, then we'd have a modal assurance criterion of 100%. Now, sometimes the points might be moving differently. And again, you have to kind of do this on an average basis. But if they're moving differently, if they're orthogonal, so to speak, not moving the same, what would the MAC be for these, would you guess?
I expect it to be very low, you know, maybe a couple percent.
Yeah, much closer to zero, right? Mm-hmm. So low. All right. That sounds good.
And that's a good MAC value, Pete, right, for two, if we go back to that last slide. That's a good MAC value for, you know, two different mode shapes. You know, we might have mode one on the right and mode two on the left. And we expect our mode shapes to be special snowflakes. Each one is completely unique. So we expect that MAC value to be, in this case, very low.
Yeah. For example, if this is 101 hertz natural frequency, this one is at 211 hertz natural frequency, very different frequencies, you don't expect mode shapes to be the same.
Okay.
You should have a unique mode shape per frequency. And so sometimes problems arise, like when we have two different modal frequencies. So these are at two different natural frequencies, but the shapes, what do you say? Do they look different or the same?
They look almost identical.
Yeah. And because they look identical, the MAC value is very high, yet they're at two different frequencies, so that's a bit unexpected. And we do that, that's because we weren't measuring at enough points. Like here, we have bending along the center. And because we didn't have any points along the center when we did these measurements, we didn't see that. So here we measured at 6 points. The mode shape is correct at those 6 points, but because we didn't take enough points, we're missing the full mode shape, right?
Yep.
And we interpret incorrectly how the structure is behaving. On the other hand, if we go over here, you know, if we look along one of these lines here, same thing. We didn't measure along them in the 6 point, but with the 15 we did. And so we see that this mode shape in effect is unique. If we looked at just the 6 points we measured, even in this 15 point thing, we'd see that everything's kind of moving the same. So it's very important, I guess, if I'm going to execute my test, and I think we're going to do some simulation for test here, we want to know if we're going to measure enough points.